हेलो स्टूडेंट्स. सो स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी विल स्टार्ट योर न्यू एक्सरसाइज, और यू कैन से द लास्ट एक्सरसाइज ऑफ दिस चैप्टर, दैट इज वन पॉइंट जी बंजी. ओके, विच इज बेस्ड ऑन योर ऑन वर्ड प्रॉब्लम्स. ओके, सो आई नोटिस दैट मोस्ट ऑफ द स्टूडेंट्स फेस प्रॉब्लम्स ड्यूरिंग द सॉल्यूशन ऑफ द वर्ड प्रॉब्लम्स क्वेश्चन. मीन्स दे आर अनेबल टू अरेंज द क्वेश्चन according to the language of that questions. Okay, so students, here I am providing some tricks. By the help of this tricks, you can easily solve the word problems based question. Okay, and those who are sharp minded students, they can easily understand the meaning of the sentence. First read the question, then they can easily understand the meaning of the sentence of that question, and they can easily solve such types of the question. But those who are the slow learner or the average students, they face some problems. Okay, so that's why I have decided here to give some tricks. By the help of these tricks, you can easily solve the word problems. Now see, so whenever you will read the questions, means here are some common tricks. So whenever you will read some question, then you will notice that there are some common words. Okay, whenever you will read any question, then you will notice that there are some common words in those questions. You will notice that the part of quantity may be given. Okay, and if suppose that we have a here the part of quantity may be given as the p upon q of x, means this is your part, means p upon q part of what? This x. Suppose 1 upon 2 of 30, means 1 upon 2 of 30 represent for what? So 1 upon 2 is the part of what? This 30. That's why it will become what? In place of we will use what? Multiplication. Okay, that's why it will become 15. In second types questions, you will notice that sometimes your word problem may be based on the area of rectangle or and square. Okay, means whenever you will read that the length of a rectangle or the width of the rectangle may be given in your question, then in that case you question may ask about the area of the square as well as the area of the area of the rectangle as well as the area of square. Suppose, and sometimes it may be the length is given or the area is given, so in that case the question may ask about the bits of the rectangle. Okay, now the next word problem may be based on STD, means the speed, distance, time. So you know the relationship between the speed and distance and time. What is the relation? So speed equal to what? Distance upon time. So by the help of this relation, you can simply arrange your questions. Okay, now so one more condition may be there, as means the most common question of this word problems is what? The question which is based on, you have noticed so many times, you have noticed that the one question is common in all word problems, that in which the salary based questions, or you can say the income of any person, okay, based question. So in that case, we will assume the income of that person, of any person, is what? X. Okay, and then it means the question is based on the income as well as your expenditure. Income or expenditure. Expenditure based question. You will notice that in one question based on the income or expenditure based. So suppose that you have assumed that the income of that person is X, then the one, okay, P upon Q part of this X is what? P upon Q of X, means X, it will become what? Px upon Q. And suppose then so in this question, what is the income of a person? Here is a person whose income is X, rupees X, and it's your, the, he gave this amount to his son. Okay, then his son got amount equal to this one. Then what will be the remaining amount? So here you can find the remaining amount or remaining income. So what will be the remaining income in that case? x minus p of x upon q. Okay, suppose that let's assume the income of man is what? X, and he give 1 upon 2 of that income. Then 1 upon 2, that is 1 x by 2, that is x by 2 amount gives to his son. Okay, then what will be the remaining amount in that case? So x minus x by 2, that is x by 2 is the remaining amount. And further you will notice that one question maybe comes from here, that the he gives the 1 upon 3 of remaining amount. He gave 1 upon 3 of remaining amount to his what? Daughter. Okay, or sometimes you will notice that the he gives to his wife. Okay, so in that case you have to subtract this amount, means the part of this amount from this one. Okay, then we will calculate the amount of that particular means the third person. Okay, so these are some basic tricks by which you can arrange your question in, you can arrange the word problems in the solution, means you can arrange, by the help of these tricks you can simply solve the word problems. Okay, now let's start the examples. Exercise. Okay, so exercise 1.f, suppose in first question, from a rope 11 meter long, the two pieces of the length 2 in 3 upon 5 meter and 3 in 3 upon 10 meter are cut off. What is the length of the remaining rope? Okay, so how will we solve this question? Solution. Okay, length of rope equal to what? 11 meter. What? 11 meter. First, length of first part. Now, length of, okay, now it is divided into two parts. Now, it is divided or it is cut into two parts. Okay, that is, so length of first part is also given, that is 2 in 3 upon 5 meter, and length of second part is also 3 in 3 upon 10 meter. Okay, then what is the remaining length of rope? Okay, then total length of these two parts equal to what? Sum of these two parts. Okay, so 2 in 3 upon 5 plus 3 in 3 upon 10 meter. Okay, now solve this one. 13 upon 5 plus 33 upon 10. Okay, now solve it. 10 is the LCM, 26 plus 33, 9 and 5, 59 upon 10. Okay, so in this way you can write like as the 5 in 5, 9 upon 10 meter is the length of post part. Okay, now then from here, okay, it's your classwork. Then the length of remaining part of rope, the length of remaining part of
rope will equal to what?
The total length of the rope minus length of two ropes, two parts of the rope. Okay.
So what was the total? 11 minus 5 in 9 upon 10 meter. It will become, we can solve like this. 11 by 1 minus 59 by 10 meter. LCM become 10. It will become 110. Now 51 upon 10 meter, or you can write like as the 5 in 1 upon 10 meter. Okay, it's your limit.
So in this way you can solve, means you have to write down, you have to solve the word problem in this way, means you have to use the language also. Okay, so it is a basic solution. So by the help of this solution you can solve the further questions. Okay,
okay.
Thank you.